Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. In this video we're going to check out one of my viewers' demos yet again. So this time we have Namaste. I hope that's the way to pronounce your nickname. If not, I'm so sorry. But Namaste means hello in a Asian country. I'm not sure which one. But yeah, I will be going with Namaste today. So right now he's a DMG and I believe he just reached Eagle. So he's, you know, he's getting those ranks, he's getting higher in ranks, and that's always good. You know, if you are not going higher anymore, you really have to change something in your game. So this video consists of three parts. The first part will be us checking his demo. We will give him feedback, we will give him advice, and we will just say what to do and what not to do. The second part will be my gameplay. I will be showing you on how I execute certain stuff. I will show you stuff we talked about in the first part and, you know, just how to improve your game slowly but steady. The third part will be me showing you how you can send in your demo towards me. It's super easy, takes 10 seconds. And yeah, you can have your demo reviewed by a global lead. I also played a lot of... I had some comments saying, you know, you're just global. That doesn't mean you're any good. But I have a ton of war experience. I played ESL. I played Clan Base. I played so much. I've played for over 10 years, guys. So I have some experience. So don't worry about that. So before we start, if you guys really like this video, please leave a like under this video. I really appreciate it. And it really just show... it just shows me that you guys actually like this video, and it just takes like one click with your mouse. That's it. So please do that. So yeah, let's let's start with this demo. Namaste. Let's see if we buy something in the pistol. We do. So we're going for armor. So that kind of means I don't have to watch the you know, the money, not so much. In other demos, I had to watch money game a lot, but we don't have to do that now. So you're playing mid in the pistol round. So you just jumped in front of the doors. But what you really want to be doing is checking if someone went down on suicide. I'm pretty sure this guy went and jump down on suicide. So he can go for a very quick short rush or mid even. So you have to keep an eye on that. That's what your goal is. You have mid, you have to check short. You have to make sure your guys on long are protected, since you guys have two on long and no one is short. So they are super vulnerable to a short rush. That's really your goal. Make sure no one, you know, pushes short. You have, you know, that there are guys rushing long, and what a lot of people do is they will help, they will go towards A and they will try to help, or they will just rush mid. What I usually do, and I think this is really the best decision here, just stay mid and watch short. Make sure no one, you know, gets short. Make sure short is secure. You know, if one guy rushes short, they are dead. That's basically the round lost. So let's see what happens. You're actually going to help. So now you hope that this guy, the other guy on mid, checks short, but he doesn't. And wow, what a surprise. The guy on the terrorist from mid actually pushed short, and you have no clue. But if you listen closely, you can hear him. No, you can't hear him right now. I'm lying. Oh, the demo's lagging a bit. You should have heard his firing. So now you're in a world of trouble. There is a guy on short. There might be a guy lower. You guys don't know, right? There is a guy alone now, and you were totally in the middle of the action, and you could have been shot from 1, 2, 3, 4 positions, and you weren't covering anything. On global, you're dead right here. There's no point. There is no way you're gonna survive that. So you're dead. You're dead if that happens. Okay, you survived. So what you want to be doing now, yeah, now get to a sound position. You can't really want to run away because you're just going to die with your 28 HP. But if you listen closely, you can hear the guy on B. If you listen closely, you have to listen closely. And actually the guy who short pushed down and went to mid. It's your bet. It all started with not checking mid or not checking short for mid. They're actually going to get the bomb down on B. But I like you just staying here. You know, there was a guy around long. There was a guy somewhere long. And you heard a guy shooting along. So you're still watching long. This is great. You guys getting the frags. And you got that first round. Okay, let's go to the awards. The next round, you go for an SMG armor helmet, which I like on the pistol. Okay, we're slowing it down a bit here. You're again on mid. You should hear and call for your people on A. But you guys playing interesting. So you have one guy on B, you have one guy rushing lower. Why the hell is this guy still on B? Like, he has to rotate like crazy, man. You're making a ton of noise. You're making way too much noise. They will hear this. If there is a guy on lower, he will hear this. If there is a guy on short, well, there is a guy on short, he will hear you. So you shouldn't be making that much sound. Maybe there's a guy watching in the smoke and he's just going to shoot you in the face. Maybe not on this level, but on here, he actually shot you. Okay, so now you just want to go as quickly as possible. You're rushing out with a flash. So I wouldn't do that. I would just rush out with my SMG. So as you can see, that was easy. So not too bad, but you know, too much running. You should really slow down the running. There's actually some chat going on. Let's speed it up again. Too much running. Just keep it in mind. If they hear you, you're an easy target. We have the buy right now. They got, of course, the bomb down in the first round. This is always a dangerous round. You guys lose one on A. And you... I'm not sure if you see how many pushed A. So, okay. Everyone going towards A now. You have a guy in lower. So that kind of gives you a free ticket to go A. It's a nice flash. But you're giving your position away. It's a nice flash, but no, with no follow-up. You're kind of slowing down the rush. Okay, they're going for the smoke. This is way too quick. This flash, I know what you're trying to do. This is way too quick. Your teammates are never in position. The smoke has just popped. They won't be near. I'm pretty sure on global for sure this... Okay, it's not happening right now. They're all close together. But on global, there's going to be a guy in pit. And they know that there is a possibility for a flash. So there's one guy going to be in pit. And if you throw the flash, he's just going to shoot you. Maybe there's a guy behind, you know, he's on the platform or whatever. It doesn't matter. But this flash is way too quick. You're kind of suiciding. You might get a frag here. You know, okay, you got them all flashed. But it's because they didn't have anyone back here or back here. It's just sloppy on their part. He didn't even get the kill because this guy already went over. So whatever happens now doesn't matter. I don't think the decision. It is too rushed. Slow it down. They have to push, not you. And you had a stronger position in my opinion. Because you still had the guy on A. You knew what was going on. There was no really time. There was no point in rushing, I felt. Of course, you know, surprising them is something. Okay, this disappoints me. Why the hell? What are we buying? We have one guy not buying anything. He is not AFK. I don't think, is he? Maybe he is. But we have, like, what the hell are we doing? We have two pistols. We have two arms. We have armor helmets everywhere. Although, you know, AKs, they don't care about that helmet. It's sloppy play. Don't do this. This is just bad. Make sure you all buy together or you don't. Or go for pistols if you really are so hungry to buy. Pistols are so strong, guys. So, and you know, if you're going to lose this round, next round will just be a fuck up. Now you're checking mid. You're making too much noise again. A guy on lower will hear you, but we will see what happens. Just watch short. Your mission is short. You didn't hear an AWP yet. Pretty sure this guy saw you. Okay, you're just randomly fire. You're just shooting randomly. He's gonna hear this. He's gonna hear this. You're an easy target right now. I just feel you can your gameplay, your movement looks really well, but it's just those decisions, those too much noise, too much pushing. I don't know. There's small things. If you improve those, it's a world of difference. So you guys going for a pistol force now again. Oh yeah, he saved the gun. That's nice. Let me actually quickly. This is just as important as anything. So you couldn't have went for anything. So that's fine. That's a nade. You're running again. So they're gonna hear you. Less running, that's all I can say. I will stop talking about it. So this push. This push is really nice. I would have waited a little bit because you have a friend pushing long. Wait a little bit. Get him towards top mid. That's when your moment to push. You should hear the guy on lower. You do hear him. This should be a free kill. Well, it's not free, of course. But wait, you should have waited a little bit. Now the guy gets the kill. But maybe if you waited a little bit, it would have been a kill for you guys without any of you dying. Okay, next round. Let's speed. Oops. Oh my god. Okay, let's speed it up yet again. Those are small things. If you change them, you're gonna improve your game by so much. Because that's really the difference between winning a round and losing. Okay, I like this. The smoke. And now the nice position. Something I just want to talk about. Okay, this is sound. It's all sound. This guy was super close to the box here. There might be a possibility that the guy was close on the right and hurt you. So, okay, what can you make of this? The guy, the terrorist, the terrorist will think, okay, I hear one of the guys leaving B. That means there should be only one guy or maybe no guy on B anymore. Well, he's gonna think at least one. So let's say he spots this guy. Let's say he spots him and they fire at each other and he just jumps away. Then he thinks, okay, now I can rush. Now it's my time to push. He throws down the smoke and he's rushing. But you are just, you know, casually staying here. So that's why sound is so important. You can just hear your opponents, but you can also, you know, make those tactical mind fucks. You know, you're mind playing them. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay, you hear the terrorist. You know that he is there for sure. You guys getting the kill here. That's nice. You're not rotating. Loving that. You know there is a guy on B. It's good decision making overall. So far, I only think, you know, for now, I only have to really check or show you how to hold certain sides or position. So I like what you're doing right now. They're going for an A push. I'm not sure how well this called, but you guys have so much towards B, and it would be such a waste now. You're pushing now, which is nice, and you're still taking it slow. So you can make a decision here, or we help them. So we go to CT spawn and help them, or like you, we are pushing slowly. But I really hope. What are your teammates doing? Like, what are they covering? I think he covers mid, but there are two mid. They really have to take them. We are not talking about them, of course. You're doing an okay job. Speed it up a bit. They are not near. So I like this. This is not bad at all. Okay, now the terrorist pushed. Your friends didn't get a kill. That can happen. That's not your mistake. They should have done better. So, okay, this is a nice pop flash. You're flashing for your teammate. Great, great stuff. Great, great stuff. Okay, now the jumping. Don't jump. You know, if there is a guy over there, you're just gonna die if you jump. That's unlucky. I will show you a bit how to fire. That's what we are going to talk about a little bit. How to fire long range, especially with the FAMAS next round. Okay, I'm gonna speed it up a bit. We have seen a couple of rounds. Okay, round 13. We have a buy on CT. We have a buy on terrorist, which is nice. Let's speed it up. You keep buying the utility, although... Okay, well, what's actually happening? I thought you had enough money. This guy should have dropped you. So just as for a drop, people are willing to drop you because it actually improves the game. You're just rushing it out here. You're getting the kill. Oh, they actually team killed, which is fucked up. Okay, you got the gun. Now it's time to go back. Don't be aggressive anymore. You know they know that you are there. Being aggressive there, just a bad decision overall. They are firing everywhere. So if you would stay aggressive, there's like 80% to die. Oh, that's so unlucky. So your team really has a problem on mid. You obviously don't have any control on short or mid or what's nothing. It's terrible. It's so important. Mid is, I'm pretty sure, it's the most important spot. There is mid to B, there is short, there is lower. There's so much to listen. If you hear a guy lower, you know it's not going to be a five-man long rush. There is so much. It's such an important situation, position, and you guys just, you are butchering it. Okay, waiting with the flash, kind of risky, although you have a teammate, let's speed it up. Okay, you're pop flashing for your team. I'm not sure if you're playing with a friend, but it seems like it. Again, a pop flash. I'm pretty sure that it's like a defensive flash where someone goes for the aim battle with your AWP friend. You can flash for him. Okay, now that's a nice flash. You know that the short rush is happening. But one thing, you guys totally leaving long open. You know, usually when there is an A push like this, there is a guy on long and a few guys on short or a few guys on long. But you guys, hell no, we are not defending long. So what if a guy went long now? You guys totally would have died. This is nice, getting a picks, getting the picks. Bit too aggressive. You know, you can also decide here. It's not bad what you guys did. Aggressiveness is not always bad. Not in this situation. It is actually great because they are in panic mode. They have to push. You know, of course, if you can get the frags that way, it's great. But you can also, you could also have decided to take it slow. So you guys did perfect here. Next round. This is an eco. I'm not going to check that. We're going to the pistol of terrorist. I see 4 armors. We see 5 armors. Okay. Usually on Dust 2, if you go 5 armor, B, I think, is the best thing you can push. Because mid to B is terrible. You have no smoke for CT. Long is terrible because you have no smoke for CT or side. You have nothing. So B is usually, of course, a B push with a smoke is still stronger, but at least you don't, it's not necessary, I feel. Seems to be a split, taking a few shots, but just pushing, don't stay behind. Okay, that's nice. Shot him in the head, you saw that. Maybe it's still then time to be aggressive. Okay, now we have an interesting situation. So this guy should normally, I'm not sure if he did it, call 3 guys mid, 3 guys pushing mid, 3 guys going short, whatever. And you know, it's 2-on-4 or 5, it's actually 2-on-5. So you know, it's time to make a decision here. I hope that guy called. So what can you do? I would usually go for the push. Go either for the A push or wait for them to push short. That's what I would do. So let's continue. You're actually going for, wow, an outright push to short. That's totally not what I would have done. What if a guy went top mid and he can look at you? What if a guy went lower? What if a guy jumps on Xbox? You're just a shit. You're just an easy target. Okay, you get 2 frags. That's great. You should have known about this guy if the guy called. This is kind of sloppy. You're 23 HP. Don't go for the battle. Your teammates. Oh, it's actually, you had 2 teammates. I didn't know. Your teammates did get the 2 frags. So this is nice. You know, you took the side. You're going to a defensive situation. But yeah, you're making too much sound. If the guy was still following you in short, he would have hurt you. Now you're doing fine. You know, you don't have to stay near short. Okay, this is an easy kill. I would have aimed for the head, you know, get the clear headshot. 1 kill, 1 whatever. But you decided. I have a little bit of lag. That sucks. Let's hope it's fixed soon. Oh, I hate this so much. This usually fixes it. Okay, there we go, it's fixed. Let's not fuck up again. We have the, well, this is a pistol round. So that was nice. Now going back, they might throw some nades. I like your play. You're doing not. I really see. You know, if you change a few things, if your aim gets a little bit better, I see progression. Global lead in the making, for sure. While you see the guy, don't shoot, and you go back. Okay, interesting situation here. They push mid. You should see the guy lower. That's an easy target for you. You actually jump down, super aggressive. Yeah, that's. It's too aggressive. How to say that? Like, analyze the situation a bit more. You saw the guy lower, you didn't see him, you just jumped down, went for the easy kill, I guess. Okay, let's go to the next round. We're gonna skip a couple. It's a close game, which I'm happy with. Okay, we're going to 12-12. We have a buy round from both. Let's speed it up again. We have two AWPs. We have one. Okay. We have one guy with a pistol. You had enough money to drop. Why not drop the guy? I don't know what happened during the game. Maybe he was trolling, but buy for him, please. Even if they don't ask, just check everyone's money. And if he doesn't have enough, buy him a gun. It's so cheap. And it will make you... It will give you such a higher percentage to win the round. So just do that. Going for the rush. Nice cover from your teammate. It's actually perfect how you rush. Beef, you know, you go to the right side while your teammate covers you from the left side. This is nice. The bomb wasn't down yet and you were holding a nade. What if the guy, you know, wanted to go for the suicide? You would have been in a world of trouble. Flash is a bit too short. You know, side is covered right now. They won't be pushing. They have two. You guys have two perfect smokes here. Wait for the flashes a bit, you know. Maybe throw them when they are throwing flashes. Do something, but wait a bit. Or maybe throw them now. Like now, only 3 seconds later would have been a game changer. Okay, they're saving. Let's go to the next round. They went for the save. It's funny to see. I've been DMG. It's been a while ago. But people weren't saving in distinguished. Interesting. Next round, AKs, utility, all the good stuff. Okay, you decide to be super defensive. So what you have to keep in mind, lower is open. You have to tell your teammates. You have to tell your teammates. And it's again a sound thingy. If you listen closely, you can hear there's an AWP on B and there's a guy shooting with an M4 on B very far away. So that basically means that tunnel is clear. There's a smoke now that should really ring a bell to you. Improve sound. I would love to make a guide on sound. There's a few tweaks you can do. There's a few things. This is nice, waiting for your opponent. You died there. It happens. Let's go to the next round. I think we have seen a lot. There are small things to improve. I would love to do another demo because I see a lot of progression. I've actually added this guy and then gave him, you know, he asked me some questions about settings and all that. I've been helping him a bit already. That's nice. That's really nice. There's a pop flash. He is not in the perfect... Super aggressive. This is nice. Man, I see potential. I see so much potential with you. I love it. I've seen worse people on Legendary Eagle. Ah, that's unlucky. That's not bad. That's a pretty good... you should really move closer. Yeah, finally they're getting the kill. Should have went closer. You hear the guy firing. It's still a sound thing. That's where you really can improve. Maybe get a better headset. Maybe change some settings in your sound. It's going to make a ton of difference. Okay, I should actually just go to the next round. It's a close round. We will finish it up. We'll watch both of these rounds. You're going for the same. I love the flash. They're totally flash. The nade. You're still staying. Going for the peak, there's no one showing here. So this should be a free long for you guys. Still flashing. St- still staying. This shows a lot of patience. You've been here for 50 seconds, or, well, it's about 40. The smoke here for CT. You should know about the guy along. Because you smoke CT, there's a bit of cover you can get. Ah, that's so unlucky. That's so unlucky. The guy came from B. What I always say, if there is a possibility that that he can be on T-spawn, I'm not gonna rush just with my knife. I'm gonna take it slowly, rush out with my gun, and make sure and check, you know, stuff before you run there blindly. It's a big tip, and it's, believe me, guys, it's gonna change your game so much. Okay, we have the dagger round. You know, if you win this, you can at least win. Okay, we're going for the rush now. The nice flash. The teammate is not following up. You did okay. Although, if you go for a direct rush like this, you actually want to get a smoke down. And I can show you guys what you want. There's a smoke down here. I'm not sure if it's CT or T. There's a smoke here. That's T. But you want to get, like, the smoke deep around here. So you can actually... Orper can get you down that easy, but yeah, you're dead now. We have nothing to say. Your teammate's wearing following up too well, but I would have loved to see a smoke there. We have to dig around, draw or lose. I already know the result, so whatever. Maybe we can have a learning moment here. We are being more relaxed now, which I like to see as well. Wow, that was great. That was really weird because one of you terrorists pushed mid. You're going for the rush now. I would have loved if this guy waited. Why is he not waiting? Why is he so aggressive? Could have waited for you. The lag is real again. I hate this demo lag. I hope you guys don't mind too much. Okay, it's gonna be a draw. Well, GG, well played. Cannot shoot the chest. Normally you shoot the chest. So guys, that was part one. So we are in part two of this video. Okay, so first of all, I want to say your gameplay is pretty good. Your aim is pretty decent. Your decision making is pretty decent. Your game sense is pretty decent. Your sound, I would improve your sound. You can improve your sound so much. That's really what I would work on. But, you know, if you improve the other aspects a little bit, you're going to hit Supreme in no time. So, okay, I will show you three things. The first is the VAMAS. Fuck, I have to restart. That's annoying. Okay, the first was the VAMAS. Where is it? Let's go, people. So the VAMAS, you got on to short, or what the hell am I talking about? You got on to long. There we go. And you had this free kill. So what you did was, you did something like this. I don't know what you did. But yeah, that's not going to work. I will show you how. We will use the wall and long. So let's say we copy this firing. Look at this spread. It's absolutely disgusting. It's all over the place. Let's say if he was here, you only would have shot one, because we didn't really, did we move the aim? We will try it once more. So that was about the range. So let's fire. Let's not move the aim. So as you can see, like one or two bullets actually reach the head. So that's, it's not good. So what I usually do is, you know, when you get an easy kill like that and he's not watching you, just get down. Don't jump. What the fuck? Get down. Crouch and do something like this. Crouch or shoot two bullets, whatever. VAMAS is not the strongest gun, but look at this. This is way and way better. And it would even be okay to just aim for the chest, because you know the spread goes up and down. See, if you really burst like this, you're going to be super accurate. So you can see the bullets are pretty centered, so that's what you can do. So let's mimic it a bit. So you know you're coming around the corner and you just do something like this. You slow down and you shoot. That's basically it. What I see a lot of people do, because they can't handle the VAMAS at all, they do something like this. They spray like a madman. That's super bad. Okay, the second part will be about holding mid. Okay, so what you want to do in Pistol, what I always do is I look at Suicide, because if they are Suicide, they can go for a super short push or a mid push, so you really have to make sure that they don't do that. Your goal mid is basically, yeah, of course, holding mid. You know, you hold this is yours. But you also have to check short. Even if you have a guy playing on short, you want him to have information. If there's four guys pushing short, you want to tell him so he can make adjustments. That's super important. So how can you hold this in the pistol round? Since I feel that USPs are usually stronger than Glocks, you can just go for something like this, an aim where you can quickly get cover when you see them, or you run around like this wouldn't get you killed that easily. You just want you walk around, you look for the spots, you do something like this, you move, whatever, but keep your eye on short. That's so important. What you can do as well is get close. Of course, you can maybe pull this off if your sound is good. But since that's something you should really work on, I feel, this is not very good. Yeah, so that's basically it, holding mid. So if you have a gun, let's say here, you can hold it like this. You can get a nice angle like here. You can do something like this. Of course, this is dangerous if there is a FAMAS or an AK. I mean, an AWP around the corner. So just hold mid this way. You know, if you can't hold mid, tell the guy on short you can't hold it, so he has to be careful. Or just hold it like this, so you can at least hear when they're pushing. Okay, so now I will talk a bit about sound. I really felt that's something you can improve on so much. So first of all, get a good headset. I'm using a Sennheiser myself. It's pretty expensive, it's like €200. You don't have to spend that much money, but that's something you should really, you know, invest in if you really want to get good in CSGO. Don't pay 200, that's too much. But invest a little bit in a good headset. Do some research. I can give you some advice on a headset, but do that. Second, there are a few commands. I can talk about that in another video, in a guide something. But there are commands. I personally don't use them, but I know they help for some people, but not for me personally. And you know, there is some mind games with sound. So let's say you're a mid and there is a guy on lower, let's say he's deep lower, you can hear him, he just jumped down, so you hear him and he's getting close. So what you can do is, when you're standing here, is you make sound on purpose, you run away like this, and then you walk back and you stay in an angle like here. You don't want to stay in short or in CT, because when he walks out, he will check you. So you want to stand at a nice position like here. He's gonna run out and he's gonna think, oh, the guy is on CT, I don't have to check, close the door. Or you can even stand here if you want. So that's something you can do with sound. That's why sound is so important. Same goes for here. Let's say short and mid is all clear and the guy is on low and you're making sound like doing this and you walk back, he doesn't have a clue. I'm pretty sure we can find something like this on B as well. So yeah, I mean, let's say we are on car, we make a ton of sound, and then we do something like this. They're gonna hear that in B. So you can just go back and then you go car. And then, you know, it's the little edges that will get you win a round. It's not just aim battles, because what I saw a lot when you just went for aim battles, it's like gambling. You want to outplay your opponent, and you want to get like the slightest, like higher chance to win the aim battle. So that's basically all I want to say. I would love another replay from you, or demo, I mean, replay demo. I would love another one from another map, like Mirage or Inferno, maybe, you know, more tactical map. That would be appreciated. Maybe cache is nice, a tactical map. So, okay, we will go to the end part of this video. Okay, I will show you now how you can send in your demo to me. It's super easy. You go to your watch, you go to your matches, and you select the game you want to send me. Since I haven't played on this account for a while, I can show you that, but I can show you and download it. So you go to the game, you select the game, and you do copy share link, and share link copy to clipboard, and it will look like something like this. Steam, blah, 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 run game, blah, blah, blah. And then you will put a comment under this video with this entire link, plus your rank, plus your name, because I have to know who I'm like, who I have to like help. And I want to know your rank, because that's kind, it gives me an indication on, you know, what I can help you with. Of course, lower ranks, they need different help than higher ranks. So that's basically it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like under this video. Subscribe if you want more, and I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye. So.